Happy Wednesday, everybody. We've got a midweek build here of a car that, while it has been out for a very long time, I've never actually personally built it, yet I'm a big Monkees fan. This kit has been re-released numerous times in its latest packaging. They've got the nice retro boxing for collectors. They've got all the cool information on the side, and before someone says, yes, that was designed by George Barris. George Barris took credit for a lot of vehicles out in Hollywood and TV. This one was designed by the legendary Dean Jeffries. And then George Barris ended up owning one of these after a while, or a reproduction or whatever. So that's just some fun little trivia on there. I can't wait to build this bad boy. They've got all the cool stuff on the box. Tells you everything that's going to be in the box. Some neato groovy things in here. So let's take a look at all the parts that'll be in the box when you get yours. This kit should be in stock. If it is or not, I will put links in the description so you can snag your own. So now let's take a look at the styrene that's in the box. We've got four bucket seats for the four members of the band. We've got a full exhaust system. We've got our differential and drive shaft right there. On this tree here, we've got our manifolds for the exhaust. We've got our rear bench seat. We've got the rear body pan and the front air dam or body pan that goes underneath the nose, because this body is so cool looking on this car. We've got on this tree, we've got the top of the differential. We've got cylinder heads, water pump housing, or just, you know, front chain cover. We've got our steering wheel, and we've got our block and transmission halves. Then we've got our nice dashboard with cutouts for the gauges. We've got half of our top. This looks really weird because it actually sits like this on the car. See how it goes? So this is this part back here. Then we've got the massive long top. They stretched this car so much. So we've got that nice canvas top on there, which I'll make sure to do in a flat color because it wasn't glossy. We've got our interior tub. Check that thing out. Just got the thin center tunnel, got a pedal molded in. No real door handles or anything on that. Just the tucked and rolled interior. And look at that, that thing's huge. It's like the size of a 1/35th scale model tank. And now the GTO body that was stretched and designed by Dean for the Monkees. This thing is just so cool. I love the show. When I was a kid, I never got to see the originals, of course. It was off the air before I was even born. But then Nickelodeon in the 80s started rerunning these, and I got to watch it. And then my mom and I went to Kmart, and we picked up the Monkees cassettes. And I was jamming out to that stuff all the time because that TV show came back. And I saw the model kit, but I really wasn't into models at that time. Now I get to have it. You get to have it. We get to build this up. And that's not the least of the things that's in the box. You also get a Monkees key ring. And what's cool about this is it's got raised lettering, so you can actually paint a base color. It's smooth on the back, and then just letter the top. You can see that looks really cool there. So that's all the white styrene in the box. We'll switch sides of the table. We'll pull out a really nice Round 2 always likes to outdo everyone in the tire department. We got some Blue Streak Goodyears, which are on some pictures of the original car. And that's something we'll talk about too while we're showing off the parts. But beautiful Goodyear Blue Streaks. And those I'm definitely going to be using with the letter out. We've got big and littles. So make sure you put the fatties on the rear. We've got clear glass. It's just the windshield and the side window vents. Then we've got a set of transparent red taillights. That makes our job a lot easier. We've got two metal axles, but make sure you pay attention. The one in the rear looks to be longer than the one in the front. What else we got? We've got a nice chrome tree here. Blower. We've got those beautiful mag wheels. Look at all the cool like dress-up stuff for the engine. We've got our grille and headlights. Got our center console. Our wheel backs are even in chrome, which eliminates having to paint those. Then we've got our exhaust system. We got the back of the gauges right there. So if you black wash those and then insert them into the back of the dashboard, You end up making your job a whole lot easier, and you still get chrome-centered gauges. We got a little The Monkey's license plate. Where are those exhaust pipes? They got to be on here somewhere, or they're molded in plastic and we missed them. But it's got these cool four short exhaust stacks on the car. So we got those, and then we've got a nice decal sheet with, you could do the key fob in either one of these, and you can use the gold ones on the doors, or you could use the ones with the black cutouts. Now, there are some debates, and we got our gauge faces here, too. Oh, look at that. We got gauge faces. So you can actually just stick those and stick them in the back. We got all the gauge faces on there. We got the Monkey's car for that license plate. Excellent. A lot more stuff on that decal sheet than I thought was going to be there. So there's a lot of debate out there, and pictures show both versions. So as always, you should build your model for you. Some of the versions show a light tan top and a tan interior and a tan dashboard. Others show black flooring, white interior, white seats, and a black dashboard with a white top. You should really decide how you want to build it. Now, I like this look, but I did see online the pictures of actual Dean sitting in the car showed a white interior with black flooring, but then a tan dashboard and a tan steering wheel out of a stock GTO. So that's probably the way I'm going to go, but it showed a white top on that one. So I'm going to decide my colors on my model, build it my way. You can do yours. Either way, I'm going to start gluing mine together, and we'll be back.
Thank you.
The assembly process goes actually smoother than I thought it would, given the kit's age and how many times it's been reissued. I thought some of this complex bodywork would be harder than it is, but they've managed to get most of it done for you in the molds, which, again, given this kit's age, is very, very surprising. First up, though, let's look at the instruction manual. We don't often look at these, but this one's so cool because it looks like it could possibly be a reproduction of the actual instruction manual they used back in the day. We got a nice reference picture of the car there. We got some nice old school kind of tips about using a toothpick and your tube thick plastic cement. We go through. The instructions actually are very, very easy to understand on this one. And on the back, when you get it all together, is a cool picture with all the guys' autographs. So if you ever wanted to like cut that out and put it with your display and all that, I think that would be pretty cool. So anyways, getting back to the assembly, I always like to take the parts off the trees, leave as many on the trees, and separate the trees into how I'm going to paint stuff, and it makes it easier with my paint clamps. So we got the seats, we got the back, which are all going to be the same color. We got our interior tub, which will get painted up. Then I was able to cut the exhaust free and get that on its own tree. Got the parachute, which of course never needs to be used. A lot of the stuff on this car was just dress up. We got that nice dashboard and our steering wheel cut free. I can always grab onto the steering shaft and then I don't have to worry about cutting anything off around the wheel. I'm definitely going to be doing the keychain. We've got the wheels, and since they're all chrome anyways, all I did was sand down the insides. You saw me do that. Use model glue, and then I just have to black wash inside or use some black paint. These are going to look awesome as they are. You've got front and rear rims, so keep an eye out. You've got short and long, so read the instruction manual. Make sure you remember which one to put where on the car. I glued the blower together with super glue and used activator. That's that clear liquid you see me dripping on there. And what that does is makes the super glue dry instantly within like 1 second. So the blower, I'm going to paint a metallic color on its own. But the blower scoop, I glued together much more carefully. And that I'll use as is, except I'll tint in, of course, the butterflies on the blower cover there. And then whatever this part is, I didn't even look in the manual, but it's got this chrome line here. It's got this cool moto meter on the top. It's got the blower belt cover, and then the blower sits back here because this wasn't operational on the car that I know of. And so this will all sit back here and be dress up, and it will plop in. It goes in like something like that. You know, obviously it doesn't sit crooked like that, but it drops in, and then we'll be able to black wash things and decorate them and whatnot, make it look kind of cool. So that's held together with super glue. We've got our chassis here. The chassis itself doesn't require any work. We've got our differential and drive shaft put together. We'll glue those in, and because they use these large pins, we can just attach those at any time we want. The engine itself, I did glue the plate for the blower down, the plate there, and then I will paint that by hand as well as the magneto. Well, we've got our exhaust and everything, the oil pan and whatnot attach as chrome later. Nice representation of the engine that we're probably really not going to see a lot of once it's covered. The hood doesn't open. It's covered by this giant piece of dress-up chrome to look cool. And then the engine just sits down there doing all the work. So the chassis itself will just get painted a basic color and then maybe accented with some dry brushing, maybe paint the fuel tank, but that will be it. Surprisingly, the body and everything went together much easier than I ever thought it would. The top went together nicely, and then you saw me test fit that and then add more glue. That just centers itself right in between the rear quarter panels and sits on there, so you can take this off at any time to look inside the Monkey Mobile. Then the body itself, we got the nose on. Now you could sand this and perfect that nose fit. I don't worry about that on a quick review. I build them as they are for the most part, unless it's really bad. We've got our exhaust outlets in here. You can glue those in later. I've got them on there, and by the way, the exhaust outlets are on the tree. They're sitting right there. They just looked flat there, and I didn't quite notice them holding it on camera. But yeah, that's our exhaust tips there, and I don't think those work either because the car's got full exhaust. So we've got our exhaust tip holders here glued in, and they do fit nice. You can see them tuck into the fenders on both sides. And then we've got our rear pan glued in. with our little license plate, our parachutes and our taillights will fit in there. You really don't need to worry about filling any of these gaps in because the parachute and the taillights fit all that. But of course, if you wanted to ram putty in there for some reason and fill all that in, knock yourself out, but it fits nicely. So I was very impressed with the fit on this vintage style kit. I'm glad I'm building it for the show. I'm going to get everything over into its paint job and I'll see you over there.
Thank you. Thank you.
back at it on my monkey mobile. We've got things glued together. The interior presses into four nice pegs that we showed on the chassis. When you see the chassis flipped over, we've got the engine glued in place. And the engine really never gets seen again in this car. So if you want to detail it, detail it. If you want to cut the hood open and stuff like that, go for it. But the hood, the engine and stuff, the dress-up part, actually presses into the top of the hood. So if you cut the hood out, you'll be able to lift it and just see the blank top of the engine underneath it. That's all you're going to see. But what you will see is that really sharp-looking dashboard in the interior. Really nice. Got the gauges on the bottom, got the center console, got the four seats for the band and the passenger seat all the way in the back for the groovy chicks that want to hang out. Underneath, very basic detail. I didn't go into much into it. Did the fuel tank, did the exhaust, which just stops right after the rear axle. Glued all that in place. Everything fits fine. The wheels fit on the tires. Make sure you put the fat tires in the back and the wider axle in the back. And then we got that gorgeous set of wheels and tires, and they look so nice. A little bit of black in there to make those mags look awesome. And that's it. That's it for the chassis. Then we get to the super cool keychain. I did that in a metallic red, darker than the body, and then used the gold pen to highlight the monkey like it's going to be on the side of the car. So I thought that was really cool. Nice little extra piece. You can always throw that in the back. It looks like a guitar, of course. You know, you got your adjustments, you got the guitar shape to it. So you can always throw that in the car, throw that in the cargo area, whatever you want with it. I think that's a cool little addition. You could also haul your keys with it. These side vents on the windshield, I did the mounts with just a silver pen. And then the reason you saw me coat this stuff with future floor polish is I will undoubtedly have to use a coat of, or a little bit of thick super glue, and I didn't want to fog the glass. So instead of when I brush on the future, I normally go over the glass anyways, I just did the main windshield when I was doing it, and then I won't have to brush it on the windshield. That makes the glass crystal clear. It should also stop the glass from fogging when I attach it to the side of the windshield pillar. The top, I decided to paint it an off-white. This is called ivory. It is a Rust-Oleum color, and then I flat coated it. Then I did the trim with Molotow pen all the way around, trimmed in the back glass or the back opening, and that will sit on the body. And I like that look. Now, the instruction manual says do the top and interior tan, red body, black chassis and engine. But like we talked about, there's so many variations of this car. I went with a white interior, the off-white top, which I decided I like the look of against the red and with the decals, and that's how I'm doing mine. The box top has it even different. The box top has it white top, white seats with a darker interior tone. Doesn't look like a shadow because the seats are in the same shadow. Then you look at another one. It's got the white tops, white seats, and a white interior. Then you look at another one, and it's got white on white on a white dashboard with a light tan top. So you need to build yours the way you want. And I know there'll be people that didn't listen to any of this and whine in the comments, and that's totally cool with me because I'm used to those folks. So we've got that done there. We've got the body here. The exhaust ports actually press fit into the sides of the body there. So that wasn't an issue at all. And then I just put a little super glue on the back. According to the instructions, the long tips go to the front of the car, the short tips go to the back. So if you want to do it that way, you get that cool looking exhaust tone on there. I did all Molotow trim since it was just a little area around the windshield and the top of the doors. I have GTO logos to put on the sides when I'm all done. Got some dust on the paint there. The grills pressed in super easily. The taillights pressed in. I did the back of the taillights in a silver. Push the parachute in and push the license plate or the show decal in there. So that is it. And then we've got our fuel cap on the back. This part here, the blower decoration, the moto meter, the little fake exhaust pipes or whatever they are, and the blower painted gold and silver, that will friction fit over the top once I get the whole car pressed together. Then I'll apply my decals. You know, this looks like the box top, but I like the black border on this one. It's much sharper, and the word "the" is integrated with the decals, so those are the ones I'm pretty sure I'm going to use. Those are the ones I want to see on my car. So I'll get all that done really quick, and then we'll come back for the final. NPCs, iconic, ubiquitous, been around forever, been reissued numerous times, and is always just as fun on the first as it is the last, even though this is my first build of it. Granted, I'm building the model many, many decades after it actually came out, and it still goes together easy for me. I didn't have any problems, so it must have been a pretty amazing model when it was new, because it's still being put together by modelers today. The Monkees, an excellent pop band, one of the first pre-assembled boy bands. It didn't just happen. Studios and people got together and actually put the band together. They didn't meet like, you know, like Metallica met all together and did stuff like that. This was actually constructed sort of like Backstreet Boys, 98 Degrees, Menudo, all the other bands that came after it. Monkees were one of the very, very first to do that, and it worked out so well. They have a lot of great songs, and they've got a cool car built by Dean Jeffries, designed and built, driven around. You can actually see pictures of them online. It is such a sweet looking hot rod built off the Pontiac GTO platform, stretched out. Final fitments went fine. The body just kind of lays over the top. One thing I did have to alter that I did make a mistake on, don't follow my lead. Do not glue the interior to the chassis first. Do not do that. I learned when I started putting it together that the interior needs to roll over the top of the body a little bit so that it looks kind of cool, like they tuck the body over the sheet metal. So you need to take the interior and slide it down into the body first, then attach it to those four pegs on the chassis, and then you are set to go. Those Goodyear blue streaks look awesome over those mag wheels, the four exhaust pipes out each side. Check out my little key ring with a gloss coat on it. Isn't that so cool? That is just awesome. Then we've got our rag top here, which can come off on mine so we can see down inside that giant GTO. I mean, you can fit at least three people across the back. You'd be like seven people in there, probably groupies squeezing into the middle and all that stuff, hanging out. They all love Davey the most, you know. But if they would have been smart, they would have stuck with Mike and got their money when his mom passed away from selling the Whiteout company. So anyways, a little fun trivia for that one. So easy, easy model to build. In fact, the model's so easy to build that in the future, if they issue this in a different manner or a different kind of design or something, I wouldn't even bother doing much with the engine that's actually under the hood. I'd spend more time dressing up the upper engine, you know, the area here, this stuff. I'd spend more time outlining it with some black wash because the engine underneath really can't be seen. You can see a hint of color of it. If you turn the car over, you can see the bottom of it, but I wouldn't even bother with it. I mean, I would just spray it so it was underneath there like a metallic color and leave it alone. But I did assemble it, glue it all together so you guys could see it, and then put the car together. The wings went on fine. I ended up with one a little bit farther out than the other, but that's totally normal. One guy wanted a little more wind blockage, the driver did. The dashboard is beautiful with the way the gauges push in from the back and all the decals. All the little accents on the car, the taillight, the parachute, the cool Monkees license plate. Everything just fits and works on this car. Even the windshield fits in nicely. There is no issue with that at all. So I highly recommend the kit. I will link down in the description where you can snag the newest issue of the Monkee Mobile. You will enjoy it. And if you don't have one of these on your shelf already, I recommend getting one because it's such an iconic vehicle and people recognize it even if they weren't alive at that time. Everyone recognizes the Monkee Mobile. Thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. I'll link in the description where you can snag yours. And as always, build your models for you, your way, and have a fun time doing it.